the young of Benji, Caso Benji, Nazabe, Shimujita, Casa, Nazatime, it is Chet. The Yanji when 89 is in sorrow. Chiyanji criminal crimes is with Nilia Petching as rejection. Then did you marry? Sabot to be the Ilia Ninja and the Society Kunia, Chicosia, Society, Tavos, Gemini, Dida Jigda, Boba Leata, Chicos, the sense of responsibility and sense of dignity.
So, if we were to follow the sentiments expressed here, the natural kind of extension of that would be, or application of that would be, for example, in society, amongst ordinary people, there is a temptation or tendency to reject certain group of people as kind of, in some sense, you know, making them marginalized and not really wanting to embrace them within the wider, within the fold of the wider community, such as people who are branded as criminals and so on, ex-convicts and so on. In these contexts, I mean, in these cases, it is even more important for the practitioners to go, you know, go the extra length to try to embrace them, so that not only are they given a second chance, but also they are given a chance to restore their sense of self-esteem, give them a sense of confidence, and also a feeling of acceptance within the community. Similarly, within a wider society, sometimes there is also a kind of a temptation to kind of ignore or deny any existence of incurable illnesses, such as AIDS and so on, thinking that it's something that does not happen to me. And there is a kind of a tendency or temptation to just put a blind. And in these cases too, a true practitioner should deliberately reflect upon these phenomena and try to sort of accept them and cultivate one's mind so that one can sort of empathize and one can relate to them in the right manner.
Then, Shalonga, Dala Shenji Tato, Shigula, some milk, Tonga Rangel, never the Kagashan of the shores. Now, Jidanga, Jigding, even Chimbutan, Shabina, Rang Manishindo, J Shenji in a Tato, Aji Tinigi Gunelandi, and Jirali, a Miss of Shabina, Tati, Chimdol Jaguada, the Chaviari. Ready in a Teleatic Power to Troyagi, Larpa Troyagi, Jimson Yedibus ready. How were to it? Dalin, Tom Chirungumaris, Tom Mishiva, only Tonga Rangelamba, the Jagashan of the Woods. So she go to Dala. So she go to Dal to Devis Madochi, Shanda consequences, Mabajina, that bet Tonga Kiwolichevri. Tonga Kiwolichevri.
So the fifth verse reads, whenever others, due to their jealousy, revile and treat me in others. In other unjust ways, may I accept defeat upon myself and offer the victory to others. Now, normally, from a sort of a conventional legal point of view, if someone is accused or someone is alleged, someone is if certain allegations are made against someone unjustly, with no grounds and so on, with no basis, then from a conventional point of view, one would feel that there is a really justified case for reacting with anger and sense of injustice. And however, here, for the practitioner, it is recommended not to react in such a way. Especially if the situation is such that the consequence is limited to the damage of only oneself and has no other consequences upon other sentient beings, then a true practitioner is recommended to really accept that defeat upon oneself and offer the victory, so that you don't react in a negative way, with a sense of outrage and sense of anger.
But the
And the sixth verse reads, when someone whom I have helped or in whom I have placed great hope harms me with great injustice, may I see that one as a sacred friend. Now here, generally speaking, when we help someone, we tend to expect certain things from that person. When someone is close to you, you tend to have certain expectations of that person. And if that person, instead of responding to you in a positive way and repaying your kindness, if that person harms you, inflicts harms upon you, normally for an ordinary person, the sense of outrage and the sense of disappointment and feeling of hurt is so strong and so deep that one feels that this is totally, you know, one is totally justified in reacting with sense of outrage and anger. Now, for a true practitioner, what is being suggested here is to not to give in to that kind of normal responses, but rather to take that opportunity, use that opportunity as an opportunity for training and lesson and teaching, and regard that person as a true teacher of patience, because that's, you know, that's when the training of patience is most needed, and seeing that person as a rare precious teacher, one should, instead of reacting with anger and hostility, acknowledge the value of that person as a true teacher. This is not to suggest that a true practitioner should simply give in to whatever harms that is done upon us, whatever injustice is inflicted upon oneself. In fact, one of the precepts of the Bodhisattva is that if the Bodhisattva encounters a situation or an incident where someone has done an injustice to that person, to the Bodhisattva, and if the Bodhisattva lets that incident pass without any kind of counter action, if there is any possibility of, if there is any danger of perpetuating on the part of the perpetrator of that crime and negative actions in the future, and also if there are consequences which affect the lives of other sentient beings, then in fact, it is one of the precepts of the Bodhisattvas to respond to that kind of injustice with strong countermeasure. So therefore, what is required here is a sensitivity to context. If the context is such that letting pass that particular injustice has no wider consequences both upon the perpetrator of the crime or the injustice, or upon other sentient beings, then one should let it pass. But on the other hand, if it does have negative consequences, both on the perpetrator and also upon other sentient beings, then one has to react with a strong countermeasure. And the seventh verse reads, "In short, may I offer both directly and indirectly all joy and benefits to all beings, my mothers, and may I myself secretly take on all of their hurt and suffering." Now, this the verse is such, so strong, that at least at the level of thought, one can take upon oneself the sufferings and pains and hurt, and also the negativities which lie at the root of these sufferings. One can take upon oneself, at least in thought, all these negativities and sufferings, and one can share, or one can offer all the positive qualities that one has, such as one's joys, the causes of joys, roots of virtue, and positive actions, and so on. One offers these positive qualities towards other sentient beings, and the word secretly, the adjective secretly, here suggests that this is a, I mean, so he here.